Once upon a time, there was a little ogre named Shrek, who lived with his parents in a bog by a tree. It was a pretty nasty place, but he was happy, because ogres like nasty. On his 7th birthday, the little ogre's parents sat him down to talk, just as all ogre parents had for hundreds of years before.
Although we want you here, the rules are very clear.
Now you're 7.
Now you're 7. So it's time to go away. Your mama packed a sandwich for your trip.
Your papa packed your boots in case of snow.
You're gonna make us proud. No backing up allowed.
Just keep walking.
Just keep walking, and you'll find somewhere to go. It's a big, bright, beautiful world, with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream, and every dream comes true. But not for you. A big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. And just around the bend, there's a friend or two, but not for you.
Once upon a time, there lived a little princess named Fiona, who lived in a kingdom far, far away. One fateful day, her parents told her that it was time for her to move to a desolate tower guarded by a fire-breathing dragon, as all princesses had for hundreds of years before. My cue. Off you go, wee laddie. And so, the little ogre found a perfectly rancid swamp far away from civilization. And whenever a mob came by to burn him at the stake, he knew exactly what to do. Your big, bright, beautiful world. I'm happy where I am, all alone. I got all I need, so read the stinking sign. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I party on my own anyway, doing what I can with a one-man cook-a-line. Yeah, your big, bright, beautiful world is all teddy bears and unicorns. Take your fluffy fun and shove it where the sun don't shine. I prefer a life like this. It's not that complicated. Sure, I'm fated to be lonely and I'm destined to be hated. If you read the books, they say it's why I was created. But I don't care, 'cause being liked is grossly overrated. Who needs a big, bright, beautiful world? I got my own little patch of the world. It's not a big, bright, beautiful world, but it's mine. All alone, it's mine. And it's mine. Oh, mine.
Right this way. Don't mind the mud. You'll get used to it.
This place is a dump!
It's not fit for a pig.
We can hear you.
We are standing right here.
Look, you all read Lord Farquaad's decree.
Yeah, we read it. All fairy tale creatures are banished from the kingdom of Duloth. All fruitcakes and freaks are hereby sent to a resettlement facility.
It smells like bum.
Look, when I call your name, step forward. Pinocchio the puppet.
I'm not a puppet! I'm not a puppet! I am a real boy!
That's your patch of mud right down there. Fairy godmother?
Right here.
Ugly duckling?
Dumped on a swamp! Man, I tell ya, sometimes being a fairy tale creature sucks pie sap! Life is disappointing.
Come on. No, that's too close. Too far. Just right.
Strife is never ending.
Sugar Plum Fairy.
Vanished from the town.
Wicked Witch.
They dragged me from pond.
They broke my magic wand.
They blew our condos down.
Big Bad Wolf.
But a witch hunts.
Mom was in the mud. Mom was in distress.
They ridiculed my hat.
They said that we were fat.
They labeled me a fashion mess because I wore a granny dress.
Humpty Dumpty.
Story of my life. Booted from the ball. The party's off the hook.
But I'm too awful wall.
That's the story of my life.
And remember, if I see back in the kingdom, you will be executed.
That's the story of my life. I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending.
And it's right here, not how it goes.
I always dreamed I'd get an ever after. If this is it, it blows, it blows, it blows. Story of my life, always double crossed. Always in the woods, always getting lost. Always on the ropes. Always up the creek, always kicked around and treated like a freak. That's the story of my life, yes sir. That's the story of my life, oy vey. That's the story of my life.
What are you doing in my swamp?
Well, we were forced to come here.
Forced by who?
Lord Farquaad. He hoofed and he pooped and he signed an eviction notice.
Well, not my problem. Now you all need to turn around and go back where you came from.
Go back? We can't go back.
Lord Farquaad will turn us into rat verse.
The guy is bad news.
Hey, maybe you could talking to him.
Yeah, he'll listen to you because you're big and scary.
And I'm also an ogre, which means I stay on my swamp and avoid large crowds, or haven't you read the stories?
Ha! You mean the stories? To say I'm a big, bad wolf.
Or the ones that say I'm a wicked witch.
Or the ones that say I'm a wooden boy. What? I'm not a wooden boy. I have a glandular condition.
Look here, ogre. I'm going to spell it out for you. We don't want us here any more than you do, but you're the only one tough enough to stand up to that no good flim flab of Farquaad.
Tough enough? You don't even know me.
I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending. It was foretold in my horoscope.
Can't you help us out with it ever after?
Can't you see that you're our only hope? You're our only hope. You're our only hope. You're our only hope. H-O-P-E!
Okay, fine, I get it. Attention all fairy tale things. Your welcome's officially worn out. I'm gonna go see this Farquaad guy right now and get you all off my land and back where you came from.
Yeah! Time to say goodbye.
I'll be right back.
Time to save a moose.
Don't get comfortable.
Over on the loose.
And don't touch my...
Time to say goodbye.
Oh, this can't be right. I'm all turned around. I took a right at the candy house past that weird old woman in the shoe, and then took a left at Caligny Circle. Oh, what's this?
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, your voice is over here!
Help a donkey out, would ya?
It's hideous!
Well, that's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, ogre, and let us at him.
I don't want to die.
Why? What did he do?
He's a talking donkey, a freak of nature, as are you, you unsavory beast.
Hey, now you're going the right way for a smart bottom, you are.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I am authorized to place you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? Now, this is the part where you ran away. And don't come back!
Can I just say that was incredible? Man, they were tripping over themselves to get away from you. I like that.
Good. Now, why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Now, there's a shocker.
Hee-hee. Say, you lost or something?
No, I'm just trying to figure out the best route to Duloc.
Oh, Duloc. I know Duloc. You gotta let me show you the way because I am like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own, thanks.
But nobody's fine on their own. Not when you look like we do. Hey, did you hear what they said? Man, this place is going Stepford. We gotta join forces. Otherwise, they're gonna lock me up and I cannot go back in a cage. I don't know if I mentioned this or not, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata. Whoa. That was really scary. And if that don't work, your breath will certainly get the job done.
Listen, little donkey. Take a look at me. What am I?
Really green?
No, I'm an ogre. You know, grab your torch and pitchforks. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really, really.
Oh.
Man, I like you. What's your name?
Shrek.
You know what I like about you, Shrek? You got that whole, I don't care what anybody thinks of my thing. I respect that, Shrek. You all right.
Good. Goodbye.
Hey, 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 you gotta let me go with you. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Well, maybe you do, but that's why we gotta stick together.
Donkey.
No, 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 don't speak, don't speak, don't speak. Just hear me out. I might surprise you. I'll be a friend when others despise you. Don't roll your eyes. Stop with the moping. You need a pal. My calendar's open. I'll bring you soup when you feel congested. I'll be out when you get arrested. I got your back. Wah! When things get scary. And I'll shave it when it gets hairy. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. You need me. I'll treat you right and never act shoddy. If you kill a man, I'll hide the body. What do you say? You're not responding. I think we're bonding. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. You and me, we belong together. Like butter and grits.
Like kibbles and bits. Like yin and yang. Sturm and drang. Like Aang and Chang. Attached at the hip.
But not an old lady hip that might break. Gonna be on you like a fat kid on cake. Like Cupid and Psyche. Like Pop Rocks and Mikey. We'll stick together like that Velcro stuff. You be the fuzzy side, I'll be the spiky. Like little kids in pajamas with those little things on the bottoms. You know, feeties. Like donuts and, oh, what goes with donuts? Donuts and diabetes. You need me.
Way.
I need you. I need you, 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 I need you. Don't let me go.
Right. Only because I'm lost, you can come.
Woohoo! All right.
On one condition. You keep the jabbering to a minimum.
You got it. No jabbering, man. You will not regret this.
Too late.
Look at us. Shrek and Donkey, two star-walled friends off on a whirlwind big city adventure. Kind of wish I had hands for this.
Thelonious, I'm ready. Bring in the cookie.
Oh gosh! Oh jeez! Oh, this is scary! Oh gosh! Oh jeez! Calm down! Oh no, 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 no! Oh, it's you!
Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man.
Look what you've done to my legs! You're a monster!
Oh, I'm not the monster. Here you are. You and the rest of your fairy tale trash poisoning my perfect kingdom.
It's not a kingdom if you're not a king!
Oh, but I will be. Just as soon as I find a princess to marry, and I hear you know of one, tell me where she is.
Eat me!
No. I've tried to be fair to you creatures, but now my patience has reached its end.
Okay. Well, maybe I have heard tell of a princess.
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
Yes, I know the Muffin Man who lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man!
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
You heard it from the Muffin Man!
Can I go now?
You haven't told me where she is.
I can't!
You must.
I won't!
Tell me or I'll... Then where is the princess?
Fine, I'll tell you. She's a day's walk from here in a dragon-guarded castle surrounded by hot boiling lava.
Well, that sounds dangerous.
You want a princess or not?
Go on.
In the highest room, in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Princess Fiona? She sounds perfect. Except for that dragon and lava thing. I'll have to find someone else to go.
Big surprise!
I shall make Fiona my queen, and Duloc will finally have the perfect kingdom. Captain, round up your men, summon the citizens, and take that cookie to the swamp.
Swamp? That's the big target!
Thelonious, tell the royal coiffeur I need to get my hair pressed. We're gonna get a queen.
The rules are very simple. Whoever spots a horse and cart along the road, punch buggy!
Ow!
Fun, right?
No, what kind of insane game is that?
Man, haven't you ever been on a road trip?
No.
Well, you need to get out more because punch buggy!
Ow!
Got you with that wagon full of hay over there.
Donkey, if you do that one more time.
See, this is another reason you need me around. Who else is gonna fill you in on all the fun stuff you missed out on? You may not know it now, but you are
punch buggy!
Ow!
Mutton carts at 3 o'clock.
Mother Hubbard, that hurt.
You know, you're right. That was fun. Shall we play again?
No, that's okay. You win. Maybe we should move on to I Spy, or I Went on a Picnic, or something that ain't gonna put me in a body cast.
Donkey, look! Lord Farquaad's castle.
See? I told you I'd find it.
It's a bit much, isn't it? You don't think he might be compensating for something? Huh? Oh, forget it.
Welcome to the Duloc Fetch a Princess Festival. The show's about to begin.
Hey you!
Ah! Ogre!
Find this Farquaad guy and get out of here.
Oh, I want to stop at the gift shop and get a t-shirt.
We're not stopping for t-shirts.
Welcome to Duloc, such a perfect town. Here we have some rules, let us lay them down. Don't make waves, stay in line, and we'll get along fine. Duloc is a perfect place.
What a terrific surprise. Once upon a time, this place was infested. Freaks on every corner, I had them all arrested. Hey, nonny, no. If you had a quirk, you didn't pass inspection. We all have our standards, but I will have perfection. And so, things are looking up here in Duloc.
Just take a look.
The things I'm cooking up here in Duloc.
He likes to cook.
A model that amazes, a plan with seven phases.
Bum, 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 bum.
Things are looking up here in Duloc.
They're looking up
in Duloc. The ladies all look swell.
Aww.
The men are so dashing.
Aww.
Thanks to my new dress code. The castle I had built is taller than the cliff tops. A city like a postcard, a monorail and gift shops.
And so,
no one from the gutter in Duloc.
He's taking aim.
Embrace the cookie cutter in Duloc.
We're all the same.
The upshot is enormous when you can shout.
Conform us!
Yes!
Things are looking up
here in Duloc. Hey, let's hear it for those Duloc dancers. Aren't they terrific, huh? Oh. Come on! Ha! Ooh! Ah! Boys! There's no sign of slowing. We're growing, we're growing.
We'll keep growing and growing and growing. Look at it grow!
My hard work and my rigor have made me so much bigger. Things are looking up.
Things are looking up.
Things are looking up here in Duloc. Here in Duloc. Maestro! And now, good people of Duloc, the moment you've all been waiting for, the raffle drawing to determine who will have the honor on rescuing the Princess Fiona from the fiery keep of the dragon. Spin that barrel!
Excuse me. Roar. Hey, are you Lord Farquaad?
Maybe.
Does the name strike fear in your heart?
No, but that little hat does.
Who let this thing in here?
Listen, I'll get out of your silky hair just as soon as you give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yeah, where you dumped those fairy tale creatures.
Newsflash, Ogre, but that oozing mud pit is actually within the province of Duloc and therefore under my jurisdiction.
Now look here, half pint.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Oh, this is too perfect.
What is?
You're big and hulking and wonderfully expendable. People of Duloc, we have a winner! Congratulations, Ogre. You've won yourself on embarking on a noble and honorable quest.
But
We're already on a quest.
To get my swamp back.
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. All you need to do is one simple little task, and I'll hand you over the deed to your swamp.
And what is this little task?
Oh, Walter, the royal dossier on Her Highness. People of Duloc, your queen is on her way. Things are looking up.
Things are looking up.
Things are looking up here in Duloc. Here in Duloc. And no one's gonna bring me down.
Well, that was odd.
Not as odd as you agreeing to go on this quest. What do you know about rescuing a princess?
I've read the stories.
And I've read the sports pages. That don't make me a hockey player.
Come on, Dragon Tower, how hard can it be?
Oh, I bet we'll find out, I'll tell you that. What's it say about the princess anyway?
She likes walks on the beach, Tex-Mex, and lazy Sundays.
She sounds fun. What else?
She's been locked in the tower since she was 7.
Aw, that's sad. All locked up since she was 7 years old, 7 years old, 7 years old.
You're so weird.
Time. There's a princess in a tower. Oh my gosh, that's just like me. Poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing like someone else I know. As years go by, she sits and waits. As years go by, a torturous existence. I don't remember this part. She wishes she were dead. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, Rapunzel finds a millionaire. The prince is gonna climb in and braiding golden hair. So I know he'll appear. Cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight.
A classic. There's a princess in a coma. Glad it's her instead of me. Pretty maiden in a glass box. How I wonder, does she pee? Blah, 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 blah. Poison apple, boring, boring, evil queen. Filler, filler, been there, read that. 7 shorties on the scene. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, the princess wakes up with a start. The prince is good at kissing and melting Snow White's heart. So I know he'll appear and his armor will be blinding, as shining as his perfect teeth and manly hose. He'll propose on one knee and our prenup will be binding. About time we set the wedding date. Day number 958. I know it's today. He'll show up today.
There's a princess in
better get here. I want love in seconds flat. No one needs these middle bits. Whoops, did I do that? Cut the villains, cut the vamping, cut this fairy tale, cut the peril and the pitfalls, cut the puppet and the whale, cut the monsters, cut the curses, keep the intro, cut the verses, and the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting. But I know it'll appear, though I seem a bit bipolar, and I'm a vandal now as well. Hope you won't mind. I'm a fine, I'm a curse. Are you there, God? It's me, Fiona.
It's me, Fiona. Now I know he'll appear, 'cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight, my white knight, my knight in his steed.
I know it's a day.
Get it, Shrek. Why didn't you just make Farquaad give you your swamp back? You know, throttle him, lay siege to his fortress, the whole ogre trip.
You know, there's a lot more to ogres than people think.
Example?
Example. Okay, ogres are like onions.
They stink.
Yes. No.
They make you cry.
No.
Oh, leave them out in the sun and they get all brown and start sprouting little white hairs.
No. Layers. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Onions have... You get it? We both have layers.
Right, you both got layers. Not everyone likes onions, though. Parfaits. Everybody likes parfaits, and they have layers. You ever met someone and they say, hey, let's go get some parfaits? And they'd be like, hell no, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits might be the most delicious thing on the whole damn planet.
This may turn into the longest day of my entire life.
I got the perfect remedy for that.
Donkey, please, I'm begging you.
Sing a song, yes, the travel song, when you gotta go somewhere. 'Cause the fun is getting there. Yeah! Oh, what the heck, I must confess, I love a road trip. Sing a song, hit of the trail. Forget the maps, forget the guides. Before you know it, you've made strides with me. And I know all I need all along is a path and a pal and a song. So I'm singing and I'm palling with you. See, makes the time go by faster.
Why me? Why me?
This is nice.
Tell me, what was my crime?
We are strolling.
As chatty as a parrot, more annoying than a mime.
Hey, look, a cat who's wearing boots. That's crazy.
Why me? Why me? A simple answer would be fine.
This is good cardio.
Won't someone please send me a sign?
Hey, look, a sign. You need a pal avenue straight ahead.
What did I do to deserve this honestly? This ass of mine is asinine, why me?
Oh, look at that little bunny.
Oh, he looks delicious. What's so funny?
I just got the he must be compensating for something joke. Oh man, what could be better than this?
Why
me? Sing a song,
why
hit
me?
Of the road.
A simple answer,
it's the
way
to get around.
Would someone please send me a sign? What
and I know all I need all along.
To deserve this song.
It's a path and a pal and a song, so I'm singing.
This ass of mine.
And I'm
this ass of mine. With you.
Oh, you feel that warm breeze?
Aye.
Came up so suddenly.
That's because we're on a bridge.
We are? I didn't even notice. What bridge is this?
The bridge to the Dragon's Keep.
Oh, the bridge to the Dragon's Keep. So that warm, intense heat under my hooves?
That would be the boiling lake of lava.
Lake of lava? You're telling me we're over a rickety bridge over a boiling lake of lava?
Donkey, you're gonna be fine. Just whatever you do, don't look down.
Easy for you to say, don't look down. Oh my gosh, Shrek, I am looking straight down right
Donkey,
now. I am frozen
Donkey,
winter.
Come
I
here,
can't.
Give me your hand.
I can't.
Stand up.
I can't.
Look at me. Now walk.
Don't let me go. Don't let me go.
I won't let you go. I won't let you go.
What did I do to deserve you, my pal, evermore? We crossed a bridge together. What a beautiful metaphor.
Why
I'm
me?
And
why
I'm
me?
And
why
I'm
me? That'll do, Donkey. That'll do.
Woo! Shrek, was that you? Man, you gotta warn somebody before you just crack one off. My mouth was open and everything.
Donkey, believe me, if it was me, you'd be dead. It's Brimstone.
Yeah, right. Brimstone. I know what I smell. It wasn't no brimstone. Didn't come from no stone, either.
Oh, hey! This will come in handy. Hope it's fireproof. Now, you wait here. I'll be right back.
Wait here? You mean by myself?
Unless you'd rather come slay the dragon and rescue the princess.
I'm good. But hurry back!
Hey,
this place is... Scary.
You don't know the half of
it. Oh my god, Shrek!
Sorry. Hey, look, it's a new guy. We haven't had a new guy in a couple of years.
Shrek, come back! There are people with beards.
Shh, you don't want to wake her up. She gets really mad.
What are you talking about? Who are you people?
We're knights. We came to rescue the princess. Just like you.
None of us made it though!
We're the lucky ones. The rest of us she incinerated!
She keeps us around because we sing backup.
What? I am out of here. Oh my god, 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 oh my god. Dragon! You better move your fat behind to the right.
Another day inside my keep. I get no rest, I get no sleep. Cause when I start to count my sheep, you come around.
I'll come back later then.
I draw my shades and lock my doors, but still you come for what ain't yours. Like a hound dog on the floor.
Another night, another day,
but all in all, you're all the same.
All the same.
Foolish mortal.
my tail. Y'all got some real bad issues, you know that?
Forever.
You think I like this job? I'm a glorified babysitter.
Babysitter.
No one wants to rescue me. So yeah, I'm a little bitter. I'm no princess, no great beauty. No one ever, 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 ever wants me.
Hold on, I got something to say here. First of all, I am not a knight. I am a donkey. And if you don't know that by now, you need to get your eyes checked. Secondly, that princess ain't even my type. You know why?
I like a big, big girl. I like a big, big girl.
Vouch for me, boys.
He likes a big, big girl. He likes a big, big girl.
And as for you, I think you're bluffing, stomping around all huffing and puffing. You want true love, stop with the hating.
He's out there waiting.
He likes a big, big girl. He likes a big, big girl.
I hope you learned something valuable today. Now if you'll excuse me, I'll be on my way. What's the matter with you? You got something in your eye?
I'm no princess, but he wants me. No great beauty, but he wants me. No one ever, 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 ever wanted me.
Some hair or something? Oh! Oh, man, I should have worn my cup! Oh, oh great, I got one of the snoozers. Wake up! Are you Princess Fiona?
I am, awaiting a knight so bold as to rescue me.
Great, now let's go.
But wait, Sir Knight, I have long awaited this day, and I wouldest first like to knowest the name of my champion.
Shrek.
Sir Shrek, I pray you take this token as a favor of my gratitude.
Oh. Thank you. So where's the door?
There is no door.
So then how do we get down?
Why, the same way you got up.
The same way? Oh, come on, I just... Okay, let's go.
Now hold it on, Sir Knight. Don't you want to savor this moment? It beeth our first meeting. It must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
Oh, jeez, I'm like a crackpot magnet.
This is how a dream comes true. This is how I pictured you climbing in to rescue me. This was always meant to be.
That's lovely. Now hop on.
This is how the scene must go. You standing there, the light just so. Then you smile and gaze at me. Take my hand on bended knee. Bended knee. Bended knee. Sorry. And though we've only met, somehow I always knew it would look like this when dreams come true.
Shrek!
Where are you going?
Well, I have to save my ass.
Okay. Brave Sir Knight, slow down a bit. Shut-in girls are delicate. I've longed for this my whole life long. Now you're doing it all wrong. Down a robust steed awaits. That's what every story states. Riding over rough terrain. Past the dragon you have slain. You have slain. You have slain!
It's on my to-do list.
What?
Donkey!
Dragon! Take a breath, hope he doesn't burn to death. Never mind the protocol, he's your hero after all. Tra-la-la-la-la, what's past is past. Tra-la-la-la-la, I'm free at last! In the end, the princess always gets her man. And underneath that helmet, I bet he has a tan. My champion, my savior, my dashing Romeo. He has a talking donkey, that part I didn't know. Wait a minute, look. It's just like in the book. They're fighting over me, like it's meant to be. No more tower in the sky. Slay the dragon and goodbye. Oh my god, we're gonna die! And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
You hear that, Shrek? She called me a noble steed. She think I'm a steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle is won. You may remove your helmet.
No.
Why not?
I have helmet hair.
Please, I wouldest look upon the face of my rescuer.
Oh, no, you wouldn't.
But how will you kiss me?
What? That wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
No, it's destiny. A princess is rescued by a brave knight, and they share true love's first kiss.
With Shrek? You think that Shrek is your true love?
What is so funny?
Well, let's just say I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now remove your helmet.
Look, I really don't think that's a good idea.
Just take off the helmet.
I'm not going to.
Take it off.
No.
No!
Jeez. Okay. As you command, Your Highness.
You're an ogre.
Oh, you were expecting Prince Charming.
Well, yes, actually. Oh, no. I'm supposed to be rescued by my true love, not by some ogre and his pet.
So much for noble steed.
You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Look, Princess, I was sent to rescue you by Lord Farquaad, okay? He's the one who wants to marry you.
Then why didn't he come and rescue me?
Good question. You should ask him that when we get there tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset.
So?
I didn't realize it was so late. We need to make camp.
Camp? But you've just escaped.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to find somewhere to rest immediately.
Well, that's unfortunate because we're going to keep going.
I need to find somewhere to camp right now!
Very well. There's a cave right there.
Shrek, that's no place for a princess.
No, it's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
You want me to read you a bedtime story? Because I will.
I said good night.
She seems nice.
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm, until you find true love's first kiss and take love's true form.
And this is what I've realized. Man, if we escaped a dragon, we could do anything. You know, I could be a steed. Or I could even work the crusade circuit if I wanted to. I could even be one of those horses who pull those wagons full of beer. I need some hair extensions on my ankles, but I could do it. Who do you want to be?
Don't want to be anyone.
Just for fun, though, who'd you pick?
I wouldn't.
But if you had to?
Donkey.
Like, if a guy had a sword to your throat and said, you can't be an ogre anymore, pick something else. Who would you pick?
I would pick that guy up and hurl him into a tree.
Man, you are no fun at all, you know it. Is this what it's going to be like? Me and you sitting around our swamp all day doing nothing?
Our swamp. Donkey, there's no our. There's no we. There's just me and my swamp. And when I do get back, the first thing I'm gonna do is build a 10-foot wall around my land.
You cut me deep, Shrek. You cut me real deep just now. What's your problem anyway? What do you got against the whole world?
I'm not the one with the problem. It's the world who seems to have a problem with me. You saw how that princess reacted. That's how it always is. People take one look at me and it's all, ah, help a big stupid ugly ogre. They judge me before they even know me. And that's why I'm better off alone.
You know what, Shrek? When we met, I didn't think he was just a big stupid ugly ogre.
Yeah, I know.
So there's really no one else you'd rather be?
I guess I'd be a hero with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. Or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring upon a Viking ship. I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches. I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story.
one that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. Into the skies I throw it, the stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke with wit and perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. But we all learn, but we all learn. An ogre always hides, an ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish were granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast, I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. We stand and stare, we speak of love, we feel the stars ascending. We'd share a kiss, I'd find my destiny, I'd have a hero's ending, a perfect happy ending. That's how it would be, a big, bright, beautiful world, but not for me.
Stays in the dark
or all alone.
Hooray!
right, Piper.
Ah, what's so good about it? I can't get these stupid rats to follow me.
Well, you may need to change your tune, mister.
Hey, lady, that's mine.
Princess, did you by any chance eat a few of those funny little mushrooms by the stream?
Of course not. I'm just happy that it's a new day, full of promise and fresh starts. And the first thing I would like to do is apologize for my behavior last night. We obviously got off on the wrong foot, and I'd like to make it up to you.
You would?
Of course. You're my rescuer, after all. So I packed us a basket of berries for the trip, and I brought you each a daisy chain!
Aw, they're beautiful, Princess. Aren't they beautiful, Shrek?
You'll go to love them, I promise. Lead the way!
Daisy chain.
Okay. So, Princess, do you often frolic with rats?
And so what if I do?
I don't know. I'm just saying, Princess, germ-infested vermin, not exactly what I expected.
Well, maybe you shouldn't judge people before you get to know them.
Oh, no, she didn't.
So, tell me about my groom-to-be, Lord Farquaad. What's he like?
Well, let me put it this way, Princess. Men of Farquaad's stature are in short supply.
Really?
Yeah, he's a little intimidating.
he must be.
And yet very good at small talk.
What are you guys doing?
I'm just saying you might want to lower your expectations a little bit.
Yeah, like 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. Doesn't bother me. Not today. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
Oh, lifetime of misery, right? Okay.
You chuckled.
Hmm?
When I said lifetime of misery, you chuckled.
Did I?
Yes.
Look, I'm sure it was very difficult living in a dragon guarded tower.
It was.
I'm sure.
All right then.
Although it must have been nice to have a roof and a cozy bed, which is more than I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing your life to what I endured.
I'm just saying you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
There are things you don't know, you know. About me, about how rough I had it.
What, you ran out of shampoo a couple of times?
I mean about my life!
In that cushy tower of yours.
Cushy? Are you kidding? I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles, I had only bare essentials, army cot, a hot plate and a chamber pot. And every morning I would boil it, no choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation out one window, isolation in my bedroom, and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited, I'm very dedicated. On the walls the days were added, luckily those walls were padded. So I think I got you beat, I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 I think I got you beat, I think I got you beat.
Oh, you think so? Now that was a sad story, but I've heard better. I'm just saying, A for effort, thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had it rougher. Like the time a mob with torches burned my britches, see the scorches. You're just whiny. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder, would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was 7? So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
No warm regards.
No Christmas cards. My dad and mom sent me away. It was my birthday.
I was sent away on Christmas Eve.
Every
single army caught a hot plate and a chamber pot. Every morning I would toilet. No choice! I had no toilet! Just a view of devastation
was hell on
isolation in my bedroom and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited.
My dad
I'm very dedicated.
Dad and mom sent me away.
So,
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah,
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 yeah.
Yeah.
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah,
yeah.
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oopsie. Yeah, 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 yeah. Well, better out than in, I always say.
Mm-hmm.
195, 196. Princess Fiona, hi, I'm Lord Farquaad. What do you think? No, too formal. Fiona, hi, Farquaad, but you can call me Farquimus, as I have no doubt you will. Woof! No, too smutty. But soft. What light through yonder window breaks? For it is Fiona, and Farquaad is the sun.
My lord, we've just gotten word. Princess Fiona has been rescued. She's on her way.
On her way? On her way, and so am I, my fairy tale princess. I'd always say I'd be king, and now look, the last adorable piece to my master plan. That reminds me, how are the wedding preparations coming?
All in order, my lord. We booked the cathedral and the band. Although I was wondering if you maybe wanted to invite your father.
My what?
Your father, my lord?
Do you mean that horrible little man that tried to keep me down my whole life? That mal-tempered monster? That vile grunt who abandoned me in the woods as a child?
Well, he did have his reasons.
Lucky, please. My father simply couldn't accept the fact that I wanted nothing to do with that family business. That lowly, dirty family business. My daddy was a miner, so he wasn't much around. Foraging for diamonds, a life spent underground. Daddy didn't talk much, he barely said hello. He simply muttered, hi-ho. And off to work he'd go. Daddy was grumpy. My mama was a princess who left her crown behind. Daddy was her true love, so mama didn't mind. I never knew my mama, but she could have been a queen. She married way beneath her. Beneath her knee, I mean. Daddy's bed was lumpy, so mommy couldn't sleep. Daddy built a new one, so tall and so steep. 20 mattresses she slept upon. One night she rolled over, and mama was gone. So daddy was grumpy. Me and my old man, a tale as old as dirt. A bitter, distant father in a tiny undershirt. Daddy up and left me good as dead. Now he lives in squalor, sleeping 7 to a bed. Oh, you abandoned me in the woods, Daddy? Well, I crawled out and up. Oh, if you could only see me now, Daddy. I would invite you to the wedding, but you have to be this tall to get in. My bride-to-be is gorgeous, her wedding dress designer. The guest list will be major without a minor minor. La 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 la. Packs of royal lackeys playing violin.
Strings of royal underlays.
Who will not let you in? Aha, aha, aha. Tricked out carriage.
Tricked out carriage.
20 stallions.
20 stallions.
With the coachman named Raoul.
Raoul.
Big reception.
Big reception.
With a boy band.
With a boy band.
And the roar. DJ by the pool. Yes, I can see my future, and so it shall be done. It's total domination with some torture just for fun. And I will have my wedding, and I will get a queen. Once I get that crown on, you will get the guillotine. And I'll punish you, Daddy, because I'm all grown up and bigger than you'll ever know. You're gonna pay, Daddy. It's any day, Daddy. I'm off to work. Hi-ho.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yoo-hoo. We're here.
What?
Oh, would you look at that?
What is it?
It's Duloc.
Oh, Duloc. I didn't realize we were so close.
No, me either.
Congratulations, Princess. Your future awaits.
Yes. I guess it does.
Well, so much for that batch of Snuthers I was gonna make us.
Snuthers?
They're traditional ogre campfire snacks. A bit like s'mores, but instead of marshmallow and chocolate, we use squirrel gizzards and mulch. Oh, they just melt in your mouth.
I think I need to sit down for a minute.
No, no sitting down. We have to get the princess to Duloc.
No! Wait, I might not get another chance to try one of those Snuthers.
You eat one and you may not get another chance to do anything.
Zip it, donkey.
I was just thinking, maybe Duloc can wait until morning?
Morning?
Why not? I mean, I've waited my whole life for my true love. What's one more night?
All right. I'll go get some dinner.
Okay, I'll go get the snacks. I'm sorry.
Go together.
Sure.
There's something going on around here. I've been watching and the signals are clear. A nervous laugh when she brushes the skin. The sweaty palms, the big dopey grin. With a giggle and the flip of her hair, I smell the pheromones in the air. Making goo-goo eyes over their food, they need my help here and set in the mood. Oh, you don't believe love is blind? Well, I got some friends who think otherwise. And here they are, direct from my imagination.
Three fine mice.
Watch your step, girls.
Three fine mice. See how they.
You gotta turn up the heat, you gotta butter the pan, you gotta make
a move and don't be afraid.
Reach for a hand, maybe give her a kiss.
She's waiting for a move to be made.
You gotta, yeah, make a move.
You gotta make a move.
You gotta make a move now.
You gotta make a move.
You gotta make a move.
You gotta make a move.
Yeah!
These Snuthers are so good.
Didn't I tell ya?
They're delicious!
And a little nutty, right?
Mm-hmm. I guess I'll be dining a little differently tomorrow night.
Well, maybe you can come visit me in the swamp sometime. I'll cook all kinds of stuff for ya. Swamp toad soup, fish eye tartare, you name it.
I'd like that.
Shrek! I know you can't hear me right now. But if you could, I want to say a few thanks to you.
I am in your corner, buddy, but you have got to tell this girl what you are feeling deep down. You may not get another chance. Just go on now. Just open your heart and...
Princess?
Here we go.
Yes, Shrek?
He's gonna tell her.
I
can't take this.
I was...
Uh-huh.
I was wondering...
Okay.
Well, I was wondering...
Spit it out!
Are you gonna eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you? You got to
make a move. You gotta shift it to gear. You gotta buckle down and give it a whirl. Seen it set right out of a book with a sunset and a beautiful girl. So you got to. Y'all ready for this? Come on, come on, come on, come on, baby. Gotta make a move now, baby. Come on, come on, come on, come on, baby. Gotta make a move. Come on, come on, baby. Yeah, yeah, yeah!
That was fun. Let's do it again.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, baby. Gotta make a move now, baby. Gotta make a move. Come on, come on, come on, come on, baby. You gotta make a move.
Donkey.
Sorry, I just got caught up in the magic of the night. You know, with the fireflies and the big, bright, beautiful sunset.
Sunset? Oh my gosh. I mean, it's late. I didn't realize it was so late. I'd better go inside.
Oh.
I know what's going on here. You're afraid of the dark, aren't you?
Yes. Yes, that's it. I'm terrified.
No need to be ashamed, princess. I used to be afraid of the dark, too. Nope, I'm still afraid of the dark.
I'm sorry, but I have to go.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night.
Uh-uh. No way. I did not come all this way dealing with you and your body odor. Just for you to let her walk away like that.
What are you talking about?
Shrek, look at me. What am I? I'm an animal, and I got instincts. You two are obviously digging on each other.
You're crazy. I'm just bringing her back to Farquaad.
So you're telling me that you have no feelings for her at all?
Look, even if I did, and I'm not saying I do, because I don't. She's a princess, and I'm...
an ogre?
Yeah, an ogre.
She needs to know.
Where are you going?
I'm going to get more wood before your fire dies.
Princess Fiona, are you out of here? It's pretty dark.
I ain't playing no games now. Princess.
Oh my God, Princess! What did you, oh my gosh, Shrek! What did you do with the princess?
Donkey, I am the princess! It's me, in this body!
Oh my God, you ate the princess. Princess, are you in there? Keep breathing, I'll get you out of there.
Donkey!
Princess, what happened to you?
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm. Until you find true love's first kiss and take love's true form.
That's beautiful. I didn't know you wrote poetry.
It's a curse. I've had it since I was a girl.
A curse?
A witch casts a spell on me. So now, every night, just before sunset, I turn into this horrible, ugly beast.
All right, calm down, calm down. You're not that ugly. All right, I'm not gonna lie. You are ugly, but you only look like this at night. Shrek looks like this 25/8. Wait a second, this is perfect.
Perfect? Donkey, if Lord Farquaad finds out I look like this, he'll never marry me.
So?
So I have to kiss my true love. The kiss is the only thing that will break the spell and make me beautiful.
Well, you're kind of an ogre and Shrek.
Shrek?
You guys got a lot in common.
No! You cannot tell him! And promise me you will not tell him! Promise!
All right, I promise, I promise. And I know when this is all over, I'm gonna need a whole lot of serious therapy.
Hey, princess, how's it going, okay?
Yeah.
I'm okay too, you know. I picked this flower. Right over there is where it grew. And I don't really like it, but it made me think of you, because it's pretty, is what I'm trying to say. And you are also pretty, but I like you anyway. So please accept this flower with its petals and a stem, which represent my feelings and tells you how. Oh man, I'm in trouble. When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail too? Hello, fair princess. Oh, look, the moon is out tonight. You remind me of that moon, because it's big and bright. And by big, I don't mean chubby. Obviously, you're not fat, but your personality is biggish, is what I meant by that. Sorry about the fat thing, I'm on the hefty side myself. I have to blame the gene pool, which reminds me of... Where am I going with this? When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail too? Do I have a snowball's chance? Are my prospects just too grim? I spent my life stuck in the mud. Words fail, she'll know what I mean. If words fail, she'll just take my hand. She sees me like no one else has. If words fail, she'll understand. She'll understand.
Shrek? Not now. I'm a princess after all, and look at me. Who could love such a hideous and ugly beast? Princess and ugly don't go together. That's why I can't stay here with Shrek. My only chance at living happily ever after is to marry my one true love.
Good morning, dawn, good morning, day, good morning, morning, dove. I had a long and sleepless night, pondering true love. My fairy tale I know so well, has somehow gone awry. Looks can be deceiving, but feelings cannot lie. Do I love him? Last night I was uncertain, but this morning,
Shrek! There's something I have to tell you.
You don't have to tell me anything. I heard enough last night.
You heard what I said?
Every word, especially who could ever love such a hideous, ugly beast.
But I thought that wouldn't matter to you.
Yeah? Well, it does. Ah, princess, right on time. I brought you a little something.
Fiona, Fiona.
Fiona, 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 Fiona. Whoa, plastic horse. Princess Fiona?
As promised. Now about my swamp.
Cleared off as agreed, and the deed has been put in your name. Now step aside before I change my mind. Forgive me, Princess, for startling you. I'm Lord Farquaad.
Lord Farquaad, forgive me, for I was just saying a short! Farewell.
That is so sweet, but I wouldn't waste good manners on an ogre. It's not like it has feelings.
No, you're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona. I would like to ask your hand in marriage. Would you be the perfect bride for the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad, I accept. Nothing
would make me... Excellent! I'll start the plans for tomorrow we wed.
No! I mean, why wait? Let's get married tonight, before sunset.
Oh, anxious are we. Captain, ride ahead and tell them it's a code red. You're right, the sooner the better. There's so much to do. We'll be married by sunset.
There's nothing like a good night's sleep. What'd I miss?
Fare thee well, ogre.
First order.
Shrek, what are you doing? You're letting her get away. Listen, there's something you don't know. I talked to her last
night. Yeah, I know you talked to her last night. You two are great pals, aren't you? So why don't you go home with her?
Because I want to go home with you.
Hey, I told you already. I live alone. My swamp. Me. Nobody else, you understand? Especially useless, pathetic, annoying, talking donkeys.
But I thought...
Yeah? Well, you thought wrong. I'm gonna build me a wall. I'll make it 10 feet high. See you later, pal. Bye-bye. No one getting in, so don't you even try. A 10-foot wall. I'm gonna build me a wall. I'm gonna disappear. What's the matter, pal? Am I not being clear? Can't I take a hint? Am I getting through it all? Just get out of here. I was told the world would despise me, so I should have known. I should have guessed. I thought these two might be different. Well, now I know. They're just like all the rest. I'm gonna be what they want. I'm gonna be what they say. Hey world, I'll do it your way. You're looking for a monster. It's your lucky day. I'll be what you want. What a fool to think she might love me. I opened my heart and let her walk through. She wanted Prince Charming. I wanted my home back. How lucky both our wishes came true. Gotta build me a wall, the perfect place to hide. Hey, you world, stay on your side. The best way to conquer, they say, is to divide. Gotta build a wall, gotta do what they say. Gotta hide in my heart. Gotta build a wall.
We'll be right back.
to now?
40 miles north, they said, there's a landfill with their names on it.
Landfill? Are you kidding me? What's next? A dunghill? A septic tank? How low do we need to go, people? It's time we set up to Farquaad ourselves.
Right. We need to get off our fluffy butts and do something.
Wait a minute. Maybe the ogre wasn't the answer, but something better will come along. And we have to wait for it, because that's what fairy tale creatures do. We wait for miracles. We wish upon stars. Why, my cricket always
forget that cricket. If he was so smart, he would have seen that windshield coming.
Ooh. No, no, we just need to lay low until this all blows over.
Nothing would have happened if I was a real boy.
Why can't I be a real boy?
Listen up, puppet! We spent our whole lives wishing. We weren't so freaking strange.
They made us feel that way, but it's they who need to change.
The way they think, that is.
It's time to stop the hiding.
It's time to stand up tall, saying, hey, world, I'm different. And here I am, splinters and all. Splinters and all.
Puppet boy,
so many strings attached.
Take the loose,
but it's not enough.
Donkey, what are you doing?
I think you, of all people, would recognize a wall when you saw one.
Yeah, but the wall's supposed to go around my swamp, not through it.
It is. See? That's your half, this is my half.
Oh, your half.
Yeah, I helped rescue the princess too, you know. So I get half the work. That means I get half the booty.
Back off.
No, you back off.
Stubborn jackass.
Smelly ogre.
This is my swamp.
My. Me. Well, guess what, Shrek? Now it's my turn, so you just shut up and pay attention. You are mean to me. You insult me, and you do not appreciate anything I do. You always push me around or push me away. You're so wrapped up in layers, onion boy. You're afraid of your own feelings.
Now go away.
There you are, doing it again, just like you did to Fiona. All she ever did was like you, maybe even love you.
Love me? She said I was ugly, a hideous creature. I heard the two of you talking.
She wasn't talking about you. She was talking about herself. Somebody else.
She wasn't talking about me?
Uh-uh. I ain't saying nothing. You don't want to listen to me, right?
Donkey.
No.
Okay, look, I'm sorry, all right? I'm sorry. I guess I am just a big, stupid, ugly ogre. Can you forgive me?
That's what friends are for, right?
Right. Friends.
Woohoo, friends!
Oh, jeez! So, what did Fiona say about me?
What are you asking me for? Why don't you go ask her?
Ask her?
You want to be a hero? Now's your chance.
Donkey, the wedding! We'll never make it in time!
Now what kind of noble steed would I be if I didn't have a plan? Follow me!
Gathered here to witness the union of our new king and queen. Oh, and as the warmth of the setting sun lifts our hearts, so does the joy of this blessed
event. Oh, excuse me. Could we just skip to the I do's?
Go on.
I see. All right. Do you, Lord Farquaad, take the princess Fiona?
I do.
Oh. And do you, Princess Fiona?
I do.
I would imagine you would. Well, then, by the power vested in me, I now pronounce you king and
Stop
queen.
Stop the wedding!
Shrek?
Oh, what does he want? Really, it's rude enough being alive when no one wants you. But showing up uninvited to a wedding?
Fiona, I need to talk to you.
Oh, yeah? Well, it's a little late for that, so if you'll excuse me.
But you can't marry him.
And why not?
Because he's only marrying you so he can be king.
That is outrageous. Fiona, don't listen to him.
He's not your true love.
And what do you know about true love?
Well,
Oh. The ogre has fallen in love with the princess, everybody. Oh, good Lord. Guards, take this abomination out of my sight.
No! I mean, let's hear what this ogre has to say. It might be worth a laugh.
Oh, you are awful.
My goodness.
Well, you heard her.
Express yourself.
Really?
With as few grunts as possible, please. Right. Okay. It's a big, bright, beautiful world.
with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream if our dream comes true.
Awkward.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. If true love is blind, maybe you won't mind the view. I know I'm not the handsome prince for whom you've waited. I don't have a fancy castle and I'm not sophisticated. A princess and an ogre, I admit, is complicated. You've never read a book like this, but fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. I see it now, I'll let it in. I'll tear down a wall and clear a spot for two.
Are you ready, darling?
I can't.
Stop the wedding! Down with Farquaad! Yeah! Get him in your house, man! Get him back and let him die!
You filthy wedding crashers, stop them! Stop them! Interrupt my wedding.
Freaks, eh? Well, I guess it takes one to know one.
What?
Be prepared to have your mind blown. Yeah.
Hi ho!
Oh, Daddy! Hi, oh, Daddy.
I suppose my invitation was lost in the mail?
Well, maybe if you hadn't abandoned me in the woods.
Abandoned you? You were 28 and living in my basement.
Not a freak. I'm a king. I'm a man. I'm a big, tall, giant man with a kingdom. Not a freak. I have a castle.
Bring in the lanterns.
Stop the wedding!
Fiona?
I wanted to show you before.
Well, that explains a lot.
Ew. All this hocus pocus alters nothing. This marriage is binding and therefore makes me king. See? As for you, my wife, I'll have you locked back in that tower for the rest of your days.
No, actually, you won't.
What are you doing, you insolent beast? I'll see you drawn and quartered. I am king. I will have order. I will have perfection. I will have
That's my girl who did that. All hail the dragon.
were saying?
I'm your true love, Fiona.
Yeah, I know. And I'm yours. Day one way, by night another. This shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss and take love's true form.
Right.
Yeah, I'm fine, but I don't understand. I'm supposed to be beautiful.
But you are beautiful. Once upon a time, to look like us would be a pity. But now we know that beautiful ain't always pretty.
By the book, and now I know that's not my story. You take me as I am, love me as I look, standing here in all my glory. I am sweetness, I am bratty, I'm a princess, I'm a fatty, I'm a mess of contradictions in a dress. I am sassy, when I'm with you, I am happy. This is my story.
You laugh at all my jokes, even though they're crude. You don't mind that I'm not classy. We make a perfect pair, radiant and rude, so in love and much too gassy. We are ogres, we are scary, we are donkeys, we are hairy, we have bold and brand new stories to be told. We will write them, we will tell them, you will hear them, you will smell them. This is our story.
That is how the little ogre came to live on the swamp with a beautiful princess.
And his best friend.
And his best friend.
And a very handsome puppet.
Okay.
And a rabbit.
And
okay.
A duckling.
And a witch.
All right.
And some three pigs.
What makes us special?
What makes us special?
What makes us special?
Different and united, you are us and we are you.